Welcome to Stories for Sprouts and Seedlings. My name's Miss Jessica, and today we're going to dig into a book all about the amazing life cycle of plants. This is a look and wonder book, so we're going to see what we can find. Our book today is written by Kay Barnum and illustrated by Maddie Frost. Look around you. How many plants and flowers and trees and grasses can you see? These natural beauties grow over and over again, but how do they do it? Get ready to dig deep and find out more about the amazing life cycle of plants. A seed is a baby plant. It's wrapped in a shell to keep it safe until it's time to grow. There are lots of different types of seeds. Avocado stones, apple seeds, and acorns are all seeds. For a seed to grow, everything must be just right. There must be enough water, heat, and light, as well as the right type of soil. When the seed cracks open, roots go down and a shoot grows up. This sunflower seed has turned into a seedling. Can you see the sunflower seed at the bottom of the page? The shoot grows taller and thicker. Soon it becomes the plant's stem. The stem is strong enough to support the plant as it grows bigger and more leaves appear. It also carries water and food from the roots. These will help the plants grow. Can you see the nice, tall, strong stems? The plant leaves are very important. They take in a gas called carbon dioxide. When this gas mixes with water and sunlight, it makes a sugary food for the plant. Now the plant has energy to grow. The leaves give out another gas called oxygen. Humans need oxygen to survive. Ooh, we need oxygen too. Everybody take a deep breath. Once the plant is fully grown, flowers appear. First there is a bud. Slowly this opens to show the petals. Flowers are bright and bold. They have a strong smell. This makes it easy for bees, butterflies, and other creatures to find them. Can you spot a butterfly on the page? I think I see one. There's one right there. Deep inside the flower, there is a sweet liquid called nectar. Bees use this to make honey. Insects drink it to give them energy. As they hunt for nectar, creatures carry pollen from flower to flower. Pollen also floats through the air in the wind. It is because of pollen that flowers make seeds. It is important that seeds do not fall straight down. If they land in the plant's shade, seeds will not grow. Instead, the plant scatters its seeds far and wide. When seeds travel to many different places, more of them might grow into new plants. Seeds scatter in different ways. The winds might blow them away. Seeds might float on the tide. Sometimes seed pods burst and fire their seeds outward. Animals scatter seeds too. When they eat fruit, the seeds hidden inside travel through the animal and out the other end. Can you see the seagull? Looks like he has an apple. Did you know that some trees and plants need fire to survive? This giant redwood tree does not release seeds until there is a fire. The heat then makes the pine cones open. Ash from the fire makes the soil the perfect place for the new tree to grow. Plants such as ferns, mosses, and algae do not grow seeds. They grow tiny round spores instead. The wind blows spores away from the plant. Some land in damp places, and if other spores land nearby, a brand new plant may start to grow. I spy a little lizard on this page. Can you see it? He's hiding right down here. A plant's life cycle is the time it takes for the seed to grow from seed to flower, scatter seeds, and die. The life cycle of some plants takes just weeks. Others might live for a year. The life cycle of the Madagascar palm tree is as long as 100 years. Wow, that's a long time. The life cycle of plants are very important to farmers and gardeners. Farmers need to know when to sow crops and when they will be ready to harvest. Gardeners need to know what to plant so their gardens are colorful all year round. Well, I hope you learned a little bit about the life cycle of plants. Take a look at your yard and see if you can find any of the shoots or roots or flowers. For more information and lots of activities, head to our website at 4hgarden.msu.edu. See you next time.